With their iridescent feathers and regal poise, peacocks are admired all over the world for their beauty. But this elegant species is proving too much to bear for the people of Kinmen County, where these birds thrive.
Now, for years, these birds have irritated their human neighbors with their piercing cries and their voracious appetite for crops. How are humans reacting to these beautiful annoyances? Our Sunday special report.
Here in this kitchen in Kinmen, Yang Hsiu-ying is cooking up a storm. The meat sizzling in the wok came from the beautiful peafowl. When it's prepared properly, it doesn't have a distinctive flavor. It tastes just like chicken. In this household, peafowl is a common dish. Yang's husband, Lee Tse-li, who is a peafowl hunter, caught more than 100 birds in last year alone. Peafowl originate from South Asia. Because of its beauty, it is often associated with nobility and the sacred. These birds are the subject of admiration at the zoo, but here in Kinmen County, they are seen as the neighborhood pest. Before the 1990s, Kinmen County had been governed by the military, and it had been home to a small zoo. In 1995, the Kinmen National Park was established, and the zoo's collection of peafowl was transferred over to the park's care station. 4 years later, a typhoon struck and the birds escaped.
In 1999,
Typhoon Dan destroyed the enclosure that contained the 14 peafowl and they escaped. Since 1999, those peafowl have been breeding in the wild. We now have nearly 1,000 birds.
Over the years, these wild birds have caused damage and consternation.
This field belongs to a farmer who was constantly harassed by peafowl. He would sow seeds in the spring and his sprouts would be nearly all eaten up by peafowl.
They pulled them out like this, using their talons to pull up the sweet potatoes. They also picked up all the peanuts and gobbled them up.
These beautiful birds damage crops, and they make a noise that many people find unpleasant.
During mating season, which is around spring, they start crowing in the morning, at the crack of dawn, and in the evening. The locals have told me that the birds wake them up at 3 a.m.
Their call is really scary. It's like the cry of a baby. The sound can carry 2 to 3 kilometers away.
Peafowl flocks can do much more than ruin a good night's sleep. Conservationist Tung Sen-po took us on a ride around Wuhu Mountain to find wild peafowl. We spot 4 birds in under an hour. It's not because the peafowl are especially adventurous. There are too many of them to avoid. There are so many that they have thrown the local ecosystem out of balance.
The peafowl have a wide-ranging diet. They eat berries, crops, stem tubers, amphibians, and even small birds and eggs. For example, this is a standard reservoir that's home to a lot of amphibians. If the soil is sloped, kingfishers will nest there. Peafowl can pose a threat to these indigenous species.
For the county government, there's an even bigger concern.
A few years ago, residents discovered that along the coastal areas of Fengshan, there were peafowl flying over the shoreline like migratory birds. For offshore islands like Kinmen country, the biggest concern is aviation safety. Is it possible for the peafowl population to creep to the perimeter of the airport and cause accidents? It's a possibility.
What is it about Kinmen County that's allowed peafowl to multiply so fast? Over the past few years, Lee has helped many a farmer trap and remove peafowl. He says the peafowl have proliferated so well on Kinmen because the environment is too perfect.
It has no predators here, and there is no shortage of food. Its habitat is an abandoned camp.
Here on Kinmen, peafowl get fat on the sorghum distillery residue that farmers feed to cows and chickens. There is food, there is shelter, and no enemies besides humans, and the birds have propagated unrestrained. County officials fear the consequences of letting growth continue unchecked. But managing the population of this intelligent and skittish bird is easier said than done. Sun Yat-sen University professor Chang Hsueh-wen leads a team of researchers to Kinmen each month. They have been commissioned by the county government to keep the peafowl count under control. They've racked their brains for humane ways to capture peafowl.
We try some methods from abroad. Walk-in traps also work. The entire bird enters the trap, so it isn't hurt in the slightest. But the capture rate of such a trap is too low. Another way is using net launchers, the kind that uses compressed air. The air fires a net that expands, but in the end, we discover that peafowl were running away before we can get close enough.
The county government tried scarecrows and even banners with bird eyes to try to keep the peafowl at bay. After a lengthy process of trial and error, researchers settled on this type of trap, which lures in the birds without hurting them. In recent years, there's been a growing call for the county to leave the birds alone.
If what we have is peafowl having an impact on a community, we might have to find a way to face this problem. We might have to find a way to manage them, to eliminate them, or to reduce their numbers. Or we could even find a way to turn them into a resource.
We hope to be able to keep the population at a certain number so that they don't pose a threat to other animals.
A healthy population of peafowl could be an exciting tourist draw for the outlying county. But for Kinmen County, more research work lies ahead before it can identify just how many birds are needed to achieve ecological balance.